everybody. I'm about to play, or experience, I must say, Flatline. Basically, life after death. I'm curious to see if this is the same feeling and whatever that I have actually experienced myself too. So, let's begin. Start. Warning, if you have had a near-death experience or suffer from a heart condition or epilepsy, we strongly advise you not doing this experience. Well, I've had a near-death experience many times, so that's not going to bother me. This is Gloria Hipple's actual near-death experience. I'll shut up now. That's a lot of blood. There's nobody there! It's a body with no head.
My incident took place in August of 1955. I'd been taken to Middlesex Hospital in New Brunswick, New Jersey due to a miscarriage. Placed in a ward because I was a military dependent. The doctor who was to care for me never came. I was placed at a 45-degree angle due to bleeding and was left that way for almost 8 days. No one heard my pleas. By the 8th day, I could not hear anyone. My eyes could not see. I should have been dead.
Responsible.
I do not value things as I once did. As for the light, it was then and remains so my encounter with the most powerful of all entities. The giver of life on both sides of the curtain. After all, I was given a second chance. I am blessed and I cannot ask for more.
Wow, people. So, basically, this is exactly what it was like for me, too. Oh, expert commentary is in this. That's interesting. I'll have to check that out later. Anyway. Yeah, so I would agree that that is exactly what I went through as well, so it is scary at first, like she said, but then you see this white light. The tunnel is for sure there. Oh shit, what is this? Let's do the cardiologist's commentary.
I am Pim van Lommel, a cardiologist from the Netherlands, and I've been studying near-death experiences for the last 30 years, especially in survivors of cardiac arrest. Well, when a near-death experience starts, the first thing is they don't feel the body anymore. They don't feel the physical pain from the traffic accident or from the heart attack or whatever. And they have the idea, well, it's just death. And then sometimes they can have the out-of-body experience, and then they go through the tunnel, mostly with a feeling of a high speed. And you, during this experience of going through a tunnel or a vortex, you are not in the physical world anymore. And about 15% of the patients who have near-death experience have this frightening period in the start of this near-death experience. Mostly later, the near-death experience become much more positive. She's becoming more and more frightened, and then she sees a skull, which is even more frightening for her as well. And this period in the near-death is usually very short. In her case, it takes a long time. And just as she crosses this skull, this frightening image, then only she becomes part of the light, which usually is called unconditional love, total acceptance, just compassion, empathy. Sometimes they feel, they see in this period of light, or this realm of light, a life review, how they lived, how they felt in the past.
Yeah.
And this is a very intense phenomenon experience. Sometimes they meet. This is
so you see your
time,
whole life
which is not
showing
in this case of this patient.
That's
there's
real
no
people.
Time
Talking
to
real.
Experience because people can experience everything from the past to everything from the future. And then suddenly they are back in the body. In this case, you see two doctors, two physicians at your bed. She lost consciousness due to enormous loss of blood, and she was operated upon. The near-death experience is mostly a positive experience, that to accept the experience you need to share with others. And the huge problem in the Western society is that people cannot listen without comment, without criticism. Doctors, nurses, family members, and partners don't believe your story because they don't know anything about it. They think it's an hallucination, they think it's a side effect of drugs. And to accept your experience, this overwhelming experience, you need to share it with others. And it means that the first years after such an experience, which we can call spiritual trauma, give rise to depression, loneliness, and homesickness. And as soon as you've been able to share it with others, then you can start to integrate your experience into your daily life. But mostly people are silent for years because nobody will believe them. During cardiac arrest, there's no brain function at all. The brain stem and the cortex don't function anymore because there's no blood going to the brain. And you need a functioning brain to have hallucinations. And this kind of consciousness people experience during an NDE, also during cardiac arrest, is an enhanced consciousness, much more enhanced than a normal consciousness. You can hardly talk about a near-death experience because doctors, nurses, family members, partners don't believe this, and they think it's just an hallucination or side effects of drugs. So the period after can be a trauma as well. So one of the aspects people tell us after near-death experience is that they have a transformation, and especially they talk about enhanced intuitive sensitivity, which means that they are connected with other people as well as with nature, with planets, where they can know beyond their own will what other people feel, their emotions. I know my neighbor will die in 3 weeks, and he will die in 3 weeks, or they know you have cancer, and later it happens to be cancer. They know things they cannot know. So these three changes are just seen in patients who have a death experience and not seen in patients who have just a cardiac arrest without an NDE. It's not about the materialistic aspects of life. It's not about a huge car, a big house, a lot of money. It's about how you live your life and in unconditional love and compassion and empathy towards others and towards yourself.
Yeah, people, I agree. Cherish everything, seriously. Thank you for watching this. This has been a nice little near-death experience VR. And I thank you. Goodbye.